You can talk about the responsibility from architects, consultants, and contractors perspective as well. But as a manufacturer, it's the responsibility of manufacturer to spread the awareness about the product. What are the qualities of the product? What are the specific applications where these products can be used? And the applications where this product cannot be used. And this awareness has to be created as a, you know, responsible manufacturer in the market, in terms of, you know, creating that awareness in the architect fraternity. When we talk about the installation methodologies, again, it's a, you know, responsibility of manufacturer as well as supplier to create a proper awareness in architects as well, in terms of providing them a right solutions or detailing, as well as to the installer by providing them the training at the ground level. So what are the right methodologies and what are do's and don'ts of the installation of this kind of material? Overall, I would say that it's a, you know, responsibility of all the stakeholders, those are present in this project. In terms of green building, green, definitely the material selection plays a larger role there. And, you know, like Mr. Chaudhary has said, you know, they give a brief to the consultants or architects to select the material depending on which the materials are selected. So that's how it is.
Coming to my last question from the moderation side, what other material, Mr. Raj Agrawal, what other material do you foresee that would redefine the cladding industry on the similar scale like glass does at this point of time? What other cladding material could redefine landscape of cladding?
Maybe the high pressure laminates, which is available in Fundamex, Best Buy, and all that. This is one of the materials that we are widely using. And the trials with the dry cladding system, that is something that will be the near future.
How do you see this? This is open to all of them. How do you see this ventilated facade system coming as a norm or as more of a practice, which is very rarely seen in the Indian facade industry today? How do you see it evolving so that most of the facades are moving towards these ventilated facades?
It's an important aspect. See, this kind of facade, which is a gap in between the main wall and the facade scheme, ultimately that will help to keep the building clean and weatherproof.
Mr. Gupta, how do you see this ventilated facade system evolving? With this, the house is open for questions. Ladies and gentlemen, you can pick your question. I would request that please introduce yourself and please direct the question to specific individuals so that they can answer it. Over to you. We can have 3 to 5 questions, please. Please raise your hand. Yeah, the gentleman there, could the mic be passed, please?
Regarding glass panels and glass walls, etc. Now, I'd like any of the panels to say, to let us know what is the energy efficiency of glass, number one, what is the strength of glass, of those glass panels, glass walls, etc., vis-a-vis conventional concrete panels, and its safety factor. Any of them could comment upon how strong is it, how safe is it compared to conventional
polymers? I'll try to answer. See, you can't compare glass with concrete. They are two different materials. They both have different performance. They have both have different use. So glass is basically creating a lot of machinery. When you are inside a building, you want to see the maximum outside. So if you're in a contested city, you don't want to see anything out. Then you might as well build a lot of concrete walls around you and small windows.
I think the lower bearing portion should always be concrete, reinforced concrete.
Not
the walls part of it can be glass.
Not necessary. There is no rule to it. You can see, it depends on the site. What does the site demand? So, architecture is all about building for a particular site. So it's not that you would do a complete glass palace in the middle of a highly contested area, because it's very, it will not be relevant. But then if you have something beautiful to see outside, then definitely glass makes a lot of sense, because that gives you vision from inside. That is the whole idea. When you try to make bigger glass, what do you want as an occupant? What you want to see is a bigger area, uninterrupted area. So that is what glass does. And what happens is, when you use a lot of glass, a lot of energy comes in. So you use high performance glass to cut that energy. It's first creating the problem and then finding the solution. I know, it's a big debate. First you let the sun in, then you cut it, and you increase the cost. And definitely concrete always costs less than all these facades. But then, why would you build the Taj Mahal? You would have built Red Fort for Mumtaz.
Load bearing part should always be, can it be above glass?
Sorry?
The load bearing portion.
Sorry?
The load bearing pillar.
That is concrete or steel?
Always.
Would you like to give an architect perspective on this question, Mr. Raj Agarwal?
It's quite similar to what my friend said. It can't be compared. The concrete in the big structures can't be compared to the glass walls. Though we can say that we are imitating the European architecture, the Western style of design and all, but we can't compare both, because both of the style of the facade is of its own importance and its own way of working. Brick and traditional brick and plaster buildings and concrete surfaces has got its own importance. While we make malls, while we make office buildings, wherever we need more glazing and more transparency, we use glass. So it's not, we can't compare them both structurally and all. Glass has got no less strength. You can walk on up to 400 square tower, you can have a in the world there are not many towers where your skyline deck is made of glass, where you can walk and take the pictures.
Sir, you had a question.
Excuse me.
I'll come to you, sir.
Huh?
Yep.
I'm an architect by profession, not one of the experts. The topic is world of facades. The way I am a modest way this type of facade is the exterior of a building. Now, we have been taught to design according to nature and according to the social needs. And there's a huge gamut of facades which are not being discussed here. If you go abroad, and I'm sure most of you are abroad, you realize why they use glass. Because they are all poor countries, very, very poor countries. They don't need to let the heat out. They need to let the heat in so that they can impact the heat and reduce their cost of heating. We Indians, I don't know, we are probably enamored by the West. But not all of us. I still feel that we should design with nature. Wherever man has defied nature, he has created very, very serious social and climatological problems, both for the person living in the building and for the people outside the building also, because we use a tremendous amount of energy, which is going to become shortage. And I've been around the world, I've seen that nobody bothers really whether you use glass or not. Somebody, if he feels that several facades. And there are people who have, like Otto Solari, he made a facade out of a fire station with trees. And this, because he said that you won't get the place to make a vegetable, you have to use buildings to make vegetables. There are so many concepts in architecture which need to be discussed about. What I would request is that if you can decide what is relevant in our eastern region where we live. You know, we have a very difficult climate with monsoon spreading for a long period. Very 3 months of winter and 2 months of 3 months of summer. I think, you know, here we need special types of facades. I'm not denying that for some buildings we do need glass. But there are a whole host of buildings which don't need glass in the way that this is being projected in this forum. I would request you to please be ready for the discussion.
Sir, may I intrude and ask you a question? I'm standing to your left. Have you designed buildings with your thought process and give the challenge to the community here to build something which in retrospect is what you're looking at?
No, if you ask me, I have been working in computers, so I said that I have designed it. It's very wrong.
Okay, so let's say collectively.
But I have used my ideas, projected them. Some of them that have been rooted out by somebody who's gone abroad and seen some facade and liked it, whether it's relevant or not. It's happened in my profession. But I have pretty strong beliefs, and I put forward my beliefs to my clients. I design options when I want. I don't design the particular buildings. So I design the entire building from the lowest rank to the highest rank. So naturally, the facade state according to the requirement. If you ask me, you know, it could take a whole day just to explain the experience. I would rather than this forum, just what it is.
Thank you.
But I just wanted to expand the.
Your feedback well taken, sir.
Thank you.
Would you like to respond to this saying that is this change going to happen? You see this change happening?
What he's saying is quite right, but we don't build mosques and palaces with glasses. See, we use glass wherever it is required. It's not that we put glasses everywhere. As I earlier said, that it is true that in the Western region in India, we don't need glasses everywhere. But as an architect, we don't build houses, mosques, and palaces with glass. We put glass where it is required.
This is one more point I want to add. See, one thing you have to understand, we have to strike a balance, I agree with you. We can't totally eliminate glass at the same time. What glass does is it reduces a huge load on the building. If you build everything with a 9-inch wall,